Ministry of Stuff.
Downstairs, the last thing he seemed to want to do was go to bed. Putting him down was going to be a battle, but his mother was more than up for the challenge. As Karen brought Brody upstairs, Tyrone expected the bedtime process to take some time, but when Karen hadn't returned for a long time, he became worried. He checked their baby monitor, and that was when he found his wife lying on their son's bedroom floor. She wasn't injured, though. Apparently, Brody wouldn't go to sleep. The party downstairs was so distracting that he became fussy and had trouble drifting off. He'd need some serious convincing, and that's when Karen had a bright idea. He was moaning and wanted to get out of the cot. Every time I walked out of the room, he would stand up and moan, Karen recalled to reporters at Times Live, a South Africa-based news outlet. Lucky for her, Karen had a plan. Karen noted that not only would Brody refuse to go to sleep, but he also wouldn't even close his eyes, a feeling not lost on any parent with young children. But the young mother knew she couldn't stay upstairs all night. Needing to get back to the party soon, Karen set her plan into action. "I decided to sit on the floor, next to the cot, so he could see me," she explained of her moves to the reporters. He then just laid there with his eyes a little bit open. After sitting on the floor for ages, Karen decided she needed to lie on her back. "I laid back. He didn't flinch or move or try to get out of the cot," she said. After her son started drifting off, Karen realized that leaving without waking him was going to be tough. What Karen didn't know was that, while she was putting her odd plan in motion, Tyrone and their guests were downstairs watching the entire situation unfold on the baby monitor. Obviously, everyone thought it was hilarious. Meanwhile, upstairs with Brody, Karen began planning her escape. Knowing that her son was a light sleeper, she decided it was better not to stand. Instead, she began to inch her way out of the room. She knew this was her only chance of getting out with Brody still asleep. All the while, the baby monitor continued to capture the entire thing. Tyrone and the couple's guests couldn't help but laugh as they watched Karen carefully slide all the way across the floor. But would she make it without waking up her young son? At that time, Karen finally made it out of the room and rushed downstairs. When she arrived back to the party, she was surprised to find her husband and guests laughing hysterically. Not long after that, Tyrone was posting the footage to his Facebook page. The video has since gone viral, having been viewed upwards of 20 million times. Of all the comments, most came from parents who could easily relate to the tactical methods Karen used to ensure that Brody stayed asleep. The video became so popular that Karen and Tyrone were asked to appear on a South African radio show to talk about her skillful escape method. Most importantly, reporters wanted to know what it was like to become an overnight sensation. What Karen and Tyrone found most surprising about their sudden fame was that other parents seemingly wanted parenting advice from them. All Tyrone could do was joke about their inquiries, stating, "I don't know if we're the right people to ask." Even experts reached out to see if the young parents needed any help self-training Brody. While appreciative, Karen and Tyrone were reluctant, since what they did seemed to be the norm, at least judging from people's comments on their Facebook post. Since the video of Karen putting Brody to sleep went viral, the internet has dubbed her Spider Mom. It was the name she and her husband fully embraced as they enjoyed their 15 minutes of internet fame. The situation convinced Karen to start blogging using her Spider Mom nickname. Her slogan was, "'Cause every mom is a superhero in their own way," and her site offered people the ability to share pictures, videos, and other funny happenings from their lives as parents. Obviously, Karen had no idea so many people would be amused by her moves. She was, however, quick to explain that her unusual exit did help her return to her guests that night. "Once I made my exit, that was it. The night was mine,"